Ladies and gentlemen, as Real Steel Promotions has raised the stakes tonight, will you please raise your hands and make some noise for all the fighters that have performed so well here tonight. This is the main event of the evening. Welcome to the ring, Daniel Lotte. Opponents making his way to the ring, Patrick Mukala. This main bout of the evening is for the WBA Pan-African Super Middleweight title. It's scheduled for 12 rounds. Your three judges at ringside are Jaap van Everhuizen, Sylvia Mukhaila, and Talu Spampu. Your referee in charge of the action is Mr. Wally Snowball. Introducing the fighters to you. Fighting out of the blue corner, he's wearing the red, gold, and green trunks. He weighed in at 76.15 kilograms with a fight record of 10 wins, no losses, 3 of those wins by knockout. All the way from Ghana, put your hands together for Daniel Lotto! And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. He's wearing the black and gold trunks. He weighed in at 76.05 kilograms with a perfect fight record of 7 wins, 6 of those by knockout. Out of Ramberg, put your hands together for Patrick Mukara!
The main event this evening, Stephen. But everything's been laid up there.
This is a big fight, Timber. Yes, Patrick Mukala versus Daniel Lotto from Ghana for the WBA Pan African Super Middleweight title. Patrick Mukala has been hungry for a title now for a while. Nobody wants to fight him. Everybody sounds like a running scare. We find a man from Ghana here who's prepared to stand here and trade with this man. And hopefully he's trying to win that WBA title himself. He's also got a perfect record of 10-0. So it's going to be a great fight this.
You can feel the energy in the room here. It's electric. Both fighters coming out. Their interest on playing and
great support.
A few people getting involved, running in the train on the way to the ring.
Knock some guys out there with very little effort has knocked guys out. So he's obviously trying to land that right hand. He wants to land that right hand. And he's about to go home early. 12 rounds is a long way to go. If you could finish it early.
Definitely get the win for the evening. Go home early. That's probably what he's thinking.
That's what I'm thinking.
With that said, he has a significant obstacle in his way, and that's Daniel Lotto.
Daniel didn't come all the way from Ghana to be a fallover.
No,
the man's come here to fight. He's got a great record, 10-0. He wants to win. He can win. Can he win? And that's what we're here to see. Lovely little 1-2 there from Patrick. Hook to the body, uppercut on the inside.
That's a bit unstable there. Hayden Jones calling a knockout in this fight. And he was correct with the previous prediction, so we don't know. We'll see what happens.
Patrick walking with his hands down, not literally walking to finish the fight. The first round, Patrick Mukala ran completely.
But you can take a picture of the last few seconds of the round. Let's just look at that moment, and Patrick very much looking in control in the last few seconds of the first round. As you said, hands down, almost inviting Lotto to take a shot, but Lati very much on the defensive at this stage. So to everyone watching, I hope you guys, if you've been here from the beginning of the evening, fantastic. If you're just joining, you have missed a lot of action. But stay tuned, because there is a lot more to come. I know we've had the comment section running. I've got a few people that we spoke to that are watching this evening. Julian Lamont, I know he's out there watching this evening. Fantastic, a boxing enthusiast. And now on to the second round of this final event.
Yeah, Daniel Lati, obviously, we said came to fight. Didn't show much of what he has to offer in the first round, except obviously that's all. Patrick seems very comfortable, not in any hurry, and trying to land that big punch. Lati throwing a double jab, Patrick just backs off, moves out of the way. Crowd is safe here tonight. Even though we finished most of the cards here tonight, all nine fights prior to this have done and dusted. The crowd has stayed and has shown support for boxing. So good luck to everybody for showing their love and support.
Playing the mind game there.
You almost feel that Patrick is happy to go to the top, but that's what it takes. It's not a hurry to try and finish off quickly. He's throwing the punch in the head. Oh, the left hand left hook. Daniel Lati acknowledged it and nodded ahead.
McCullough actually enticing him a little bit just now. And McCullough finding himself on the rest for a few seconds there.
Very good. Catching McCullough laughing, shaking his head, talking to his opponent, really complaining, Mr. Wallace Campbell. Telling McCullough not to carry on talking, keep quiet. The things I've been guilty of myself. On a few occasions in my career, I was told not to talk anymore.
This must be a case of sometimes you have to say something.
I was commentating on my own fight.
Multitasking, if you've ever seen it. The crowd now synchronized chanting.
This is just such a warning for the end of the second round. Not a horrible reaction in this round.
Like he's letting Daniel have a go, see what he starts, and
hasn't been impressed. Let's see what happens
to
the third one as he
came
out of intuition.
As we said, yeah, he almost looks like he's inviting a few punches from Lati there. Keeping his hands down, availing himself to anything that Lati would try. I'm assuming it's his confidence playing through there. The Lati camp, a lot of advice being given to Lati there.
Yeah, interesting to see the behavior in both corners. The Garden corner, obviously, very animated. A lot of pressure on. And very relaxed.
Round three here, the 10th and final bout for the evening. We have Patrick McCullough versus the Ghanaian Daniel Lati. Australia coming in with seven wins out of seven on his score, his record card. Six of the seven being knockouts. And his opponent, Daniel Lati, also coming from a 10-win streak, three of which knockouts.
Yeah, the WBA Pan-African title on the line here. And we're obviously privileged to have in the house our WBA representative and Hall of Famer, Stan Christodoulou, is here in attendance as well, watching on this fight. So a big honor for us to have a Hall of Famer. And that's the International Boxing Hall of Fame, Stan Christodoulou, is in there.
Round starting very explosive, some big punches being thrown in, and we went into the third, and it feels a little bit a bit flat. I wouldn't say less exciting, but it seems that the fighters have switched their mode to more the long term.
At any time, if Patrick had to turn it up, he could finish it.
Yeah, we saw a few seconds ago Patrick just landing a shot that it caught him off balance a little bit.
Patrick McCullough switching to southpaw.
Possibly just keep Lati's brain working overtime. As well as his brain, because Lati's been doing a fair bit of defending. But it hasn't touched him getting one or two very quick shots back on McCullough.
Looking at Ashley Bury in the corner with Patrick McCullough, and let's see what he said. Very calm in the corner, Patrick McCullough. Calmness obviously shining through the round when McCullough comes out, he's very chilled. No excitement, no overzealous. He's almost wanting to sort of just pick it up maybe a notch.
The full 12 rounds.
Both fighters getting towards the jab there.
McCullough forcing Lati to work overtime to get out of the way of the crunches. Not giving him too much time to get on the offensive. Or deliver any shots. However, a fantastic little rant from Lottie there. Mukala complaining a shot to the back of the head from Lottie there. The fight continues. Looking like he wants to space, obviously to use his jab and get in there, but Lottie's tucking into him a few times now.
Another fight, just the first round.
Well, as we say that, it heats up a little bit.
Another holding happening now.
Watching the first two rounds, it almost looks as if it would be a very short bout, maybe done in the first two. But here we are, starting on the fifth round. Fifth round. Mukala again, eager to get to the fight. Lottie defending hard, almost closing off his face with the arms up right in front, as opposed to Mukala, who's flipping himself up. It's an indicator of whether the fight is on the offensive or defensive. The crowd shouting for the 5-6 combination, which is the uppercut, left and right uppercut for Mukala to use against Lottie. But Lottie doing well to keep quiet, not letting any of Mukala's punches in. Again, a complaint from Mukala for the back of the head from Lottie. But that doesn't stop Mukala from delivering a quite a powerful left hook there. going in for the first, hugging Mukala there. This referee getting a little bit agitated with the amount of hugging. It is certainly heating up there. Lati having a little go at Mukala. We haven't seen him do too many times. And that will be the round. Referee Wally Snowball visibly agitated by Daniel Lati going in for the hug. Is that what you would call it? The clinch. So Lati going in for the clinch a lot more times than I think than he would have liked. With Snowball.
Should have lost it on the pitch. That's what I had.
Second
half, round number six. Coming to the almost the halfway mark. Round number 16 in this round will be halfway of this 12 round. WBA Pan African title fight, triple middleweight fight.
Mukala giving Lati a good few punches, but falling down on the ropes just a moment ago. And now the table turns the other way. Lati finding himself on the ropes, having to take a few big hits from Mukala. In control of the bout, but the glimpses and they're becoming more and more frequent. Where Daniel Lati is taking control. He's having his brief moment. And it's interesting to see if this is a building thing or if this is just the last of what he has.
Past the halfway mark now. We're heading to the next 6 rounds. And as you say, let's see what legs we have on both these fighters. Lovely night of boxing here tonight. It's a 10-fight card. Long night. We're going to 7 o'clock. If you're out there watching us, thank you for the support. Thank you for watching.
Keeping the sport of boxing alive. International fight here. The way of McCullough's move by going low. Forcing the clinch there.
Honestly, with the outside way this fight started in round one, I never thought we'd see that. But surprisingly enough, the fight sort of began to sort of subdued. Both fighters not willing to sort of step up the pace much, and sort of kept it there, toe to toe, catching and then looking.
Definitely, Steve. One thing I've enjoyed about this part of the last few rounds, you've watched in particular, well, as I said before, I can't say. I can neither deny or agree to that, but it is refreshing at the end of every round, certainly. But it's not about 8.
right there. He's got to turn the pressure up now.
Marty looking a little bit stunned after that last burst of punches from Mukala. And there we have it.
Marty getting a warning for holding.
It was one point. We've said it a few times in the previous rounds. I think she got off quite not lightly, but well, it's no ball given in. Wasn't able to carry on. Referee, Mr. Stonewall.
Thank you.